Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you've seen this beautiful face for the first time, please do a thing and subscribe. I will be showing you guys how I did this face, Vogue style. So we're gonna start with edges and then it's skincare. After skincare, we're doing the face bed. I'm gonna be doing it Vogue style in the bathroom and everything. I'm wearing a robe and everything. So yeah, that's it. I'm so proud of myself. Like, get into it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Love you. So, we will begin with the edges. Because, as you can tell, it's getting crusty and, you know, none of that in this house. Period. This is where I have my mirror, so I'm gonna be looking in this direction for, like, most of the time. So, this is the gel I'm using for my edges. Let me tell you something. With gel, you can make almost any gel hold your edges if you let it dry long enough. You let it dry by opening it and placing it like next to your window or wherever, and then like you don't close it so that it gets like a little sticky and mucusy. See, when I got this gel, it was very watery, but now it's sticky. It's giving Eco Styler. I just brush down my edges. I swoop and follow in with my finger and then swoop again. Easy as pie. You can just swoop them towards any direction that you like. Period. I then lay my edges using a silk scarf. Moving on to skincare. So I use pure soap to cleanse my skin. You can find it at your pharmacy, or this is what it looks like. So I just activate it with a little bit of water and wash it off. This is the toner I use. After that, I go in with this primer serum. The first time I got this, I bought it for makeup. But then the more I used it, the more I fell in love with it. And then I started incorporating it into my skincare routine. Next is moisturizer. I use this Nivea day cream. I've been using this for over a year now and love, love, love this product. Next is SPF. I use the Derm Opal Moisturizing Sunscreen. And that's all. Skincare. We start with the eyebrows because I'm an eyebrows first girly. I use this brow soap from Anathi Cosmetics. I just use a little bit of water or setting spray. Go in with my spoolie and then brush up my eyebrows. I use an upward motion because I like a semi-fluffy brow. Clean that up. Like, I don't like the super fluffy brow, but I like my brow super light and fluffy. And then after that, I use a cotton pad to clean up the soap. And then I go in with the Wet n Wild eyebrow kit. It looks disgusting. I dip into the dark shade and then I start working on the bottom of my, I create a line on the bottom of my eyebrows and then I create shape that I want. So I like a little arch and then a long tail. And I create strokes that mimic eyebrow hairs all the way to the beginning of my eyebrow. Clean up my eyebrows using the Rimmel Multitasker Concealer. What I like about this concealer is that it's very thick. It doesn't move around a lot. It's easy to control. So I create little drops under my eyebrow. What I like to do is take my flat brush and take a little bit of that concealer and clean up. The thing about thick concealers is that they make a job easier. You get a cleaner eyebrow effortlessly. And then I use a beauty blender, it's damp, to blend everything out. Because once you don't immediately blend out your concealer, it's gonna get stuck where you placed it. And then you're gonna have harsh lines. So the secret is blend, blend, blend. I then go in with the Essence Glow Primer Serum. I love this serum because it's hydrating and gives you a glow. Because I'm gonna use matte foundation, I think I need the glow from underneath. I focus on the areas that I want to have more glow. Because my skin is super dry, so I like a serum primer because it's hydrating. Set my concealer on the eyelid with the Signature Translucent Powder. Eye Obsessions palette from Signature Cosmetics. I love, love, love the nudes. So I'm gonna first go in with the darkest I'm gonna go in with this one first. But the thing about pigmented palettes is that it's not difficult to blend, especially if you do too much. Just a bit, because it's gonna be too much and then now you won't be able to blend it. Yeah. The darkest shade with a more dense brush. And then focus on the outer corners of my eyelid. A little bit of my concealer again. Yeah. And then go ahead and blend that out. And focus on the inner corners of your eye. And I don't ever like cut my crease anymore. I just on myself. So I'm a soft glam queen now. Use a flat brush. Go in with the shade. Yummy. The Wet n Wild Mega Liner to create a wing eye. And I create a reverse cat eye. Perfect. Lash application time, and this is literally the only glue that matters in my life. I used to do this with my fingers, but lately I can't like live without tweezers. I like to then go over my lashes with mascara just to make sure everything matches. And then with foundation, I mix these two. The reason I mix is because the Wet n Wild foundation looks like this alone. So then I like to mix it with something that's a little bit darker, just so it kind of matches my skin tone. I'm using my fingers to mix. These foundations go so well together. Blend with my damp beauty blender to avoid this area, because then it's gonna crease, because you're gonna apply concealer anyway. I don't ever like apply a lot of foundation anymore. I'm leaning more towards the clean girl aesthetic with the same concealer that I've been using, and apply it on the inner and outer corners. And then I immediately blend it out, because it's thick already. I don't have to wait, because if I wait, then I have patches. And then for blush, I go back to this palette, the shade, and use it as my blush. Careful though, because it's very pigmented. But the thing with blush is that even if you do too much, it's okay, because it's gonna disappear as the day goes. It kind of like disappears. So like, yeah, and I use powder anyway, so no worries. I'm a blush babe, if you can't tell already. I go back to the signature translucent powder. Use my beauty sponge to bake. So I use just a little bit by bit. Because once you use a lot at once, you're gonna end up having cracks on your makeup. So the secret is to go little by little. A lot on the bridge of my nose, because I don't contour, so I'm reverse contouring. Even then, I don't do a lot with a reverse contour because my face is already snatched as it is, so I don't need a lot. And go in with a little bit of highlight. This is from Sashimi. It's the colors. Yeah. My nose. My lips. Brown liner to line my lips. Pinkish nude. Pink gloss. Setting spray from Rimmel. And we're done. Thank you guys for making it to the end of the video. This is the full bit. Yeah.